Don't go!
Oh, God.
Don't leave me here. Alone! Naked! Let me try you on.
Oh, God. No!
Don't worry. You'll just fine.
Not a fan of light, huh? Fucking figures.
Let me try. Most people spend their whole lives seeing only a fraction of our reality. Lucky them. I have spent my whole life looking beyond the edges of our reality. Even as a child, I saw things that would break a grown man. Eventually, I grew into it. It became my normal. But that thing, it was anything but normal. I've never encountered anything like this. This ravenous. I felt lost. I came to Neva looking for answers, and all I got was more questions. What was that monster? Who was Thomas? And what did he want from me? I woke up with icy water in my veins. I wanted nothing but to get out of there. To just get up and run until my legs give out, until my lungs collapse. But I knew I couldn't. It wouldn't have solved anything. And besides, sadness needed my help. There's someone there.
Merry and happy. You're okay.
Sadness? Is that you? Are you okay? What was that thing? Hello?
Find Richard.
Richard? No, Sadness. The man I'm looking for is named Thomas. Who's Richard?
It's on the day room.
Day room? Are you trying to show me the way? Thank you. All right. What now? First Thomas, then Richard. Before I knew it, I was looking for a bunch of strangers. At least sadness was still with me, in a way. Is that? Oh God, it's everywhere. How many people died here?
Let me be frank. This case is problematic. My superiors want it to go away. I want it to go away. You can see how your statement complicates that? Comrade?
Yes, I understand.
Some things don't just go away. They stick. They echo.
Cover your nose. Try not to look at him. The sooner we're done, the sooner we can get out of this place.
Locked. Hey, Marianne. You look like shit. Are those bolt cutters? Might be useful. If only I could reach them. Thank you.
shoot. Ah, shit!
Hey, wait up. Come on, Slowpoke. I've got an idea. We're gonna show that weirdo. What are you gonna do?
There were some kids here.
Hello? Anyone?
I'm sure they're here somewhere. No, Bernard wouldn't do that. He's nice.
Ugh, she's talking to herself again. What a freak.
Hey, don't talk about her like that.
This isn't funny.
I really don't think we should.
Shut the heck up, Bernard.
Guys!
Oh, kids can be such assholes sometimes. What is it? You want to show me something? What the hell? Snowdrop, huh? Why does that sound familiar? Oh. As I got closer to the mirror, I I felt a slight tug in my pocket. I could tell there was more to that figurine than just carved wood. I can feel it calling out to me. It was the first time that it ever happened. I touched the mirror and crossed over to the other side. What the hell is this place? Wait, I know you. You were that boy. Bernard, was it? He was trapped there, just like I was. I knew his name, but somehow that wasn't enough to send him away. It was like a part of him was missing. Spirit well. I could use some of that energy. That cat figurine was the key. I can't pass through without it. Nothing. Shit. Gotta find something to open the way. Rid of them. This was yours, wasn't it, Bernard? It's about time you got it back. I'm sorry you had to go through all this. It's time for you to find peace. Bernard.
Thank you.
Crying, tears in isolation.